Hey guys, I'm back again, and today we're gonna unbox the Styletone box. I'm really excited to see what is inside here. So let's rip up this paper and let's see. Oh, it opens up from this side. Sorry for that. Okay, so this is a little booklet and everything is packed in bubble wrap. Okay, so upon getting everything out of here, this is, stay there, the inside of this month's box. Okay, so let's start with this liquidy thing in here. This is, oh, it's plastic. I thought it was glass. It looks really cool. Oh, it's cuticle oil. Okay, it's from Secret. All right, minerals from the Dead Sea. Like secret, but like sea, as in a swimming sea, which is really cool. From the Dead Sea, I'm actually going there in like a month. So, okay, that's pretty cool. Let's just try it out. Is it like a, oh, it's not. Okay, let's see how much goes out in here. There we go. It feels really, really soft. It doesn't have a perfume or a smell at all. I can't, honestly, like I can't smell anything. It feels really, really soft. This is what that fella looks like. It's got a really, really nice tube, as you can see. And this fella is €12.95. Okay, so far so good. I see something really, really big from Cougar. This is 6 shades of nude eyeshadow contour set. What? Okay, let's open it up. It is sealed, so you know what? Give me a minute and I'm gonna tear up this little box. You know what, guys? I actually hate it when they do this, like they seal the little box. I know it's good because it's sealed, but it's really annoying because I have to kind of break it to be able to get it out. And the worst thing is, if I want to do it in a giveaway or give it away to somebody else, I don't have the original box anymore, which really, really sucks. Okay, I got it out. Ooh, and it's dirty. Oh my goodness. Yeah, okay, it's cracked a little bit. It's not too bad. Hopefully you guys are able to see that inside. I'm not really sure if the camera's gonna pick up on that, but it is cracked. So I'm gonna open it up. Hold on top of this box. There we go. This looks more like, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Bobbi Brown and they're like shimmer bricks, but that's more what it looks like. I don't think I'm gonna use this. Why? Because look at how the eyeshadows are distributed. It's really gonna be difficult to get eyeshadow per eyeshadow. I would much rather have an eyeshadow palette or singles that I can put in a Z palette, but this is just for eyeshadow, for me personally, not, I don't know, it's not practical. The colors though, I will say, are beautiful. So I think I already know who I'm gonna give this away to. Let's just see how much it costs. It costs 6 shades of nude, €14.85. And again, I'm gonna say it, I would love to use these colors, but this way it's just not practical. So I just know I'm not gonna use that. Moving along to a green pencil from a Masada. This is the Forever Cool in 205. Does it have a name? No, it does not. Okay, I'm gonna try and get this out of the seal since it is like a green pencil, which is really, really cool. I'm actually wearing green today. Oh, and this actually matches my green eyeshadow perfectly. Hopefully you guys are able to see that that's what it looks like. I am definitely, definitely gonna use this. I abso-freaking-lutely love getting this like colorful kind of, what do you call these? Like eye pencils, I love them. Especially like the roll-up ones that I don't have to sharpen, it's just easier. Let's see where in the booklet it says it is. Oh wait, it's over here. You can get a blue one, like a marine blue one and a green one. And I am so freaking happy I got a green one. Marine blue. With this particular blue eye color that I have, it's like a very ocean blue, but not like a dark ocean, like a tropical ocean blue with green. I got the green from my mom, and that combination and navy blue does not suit me whatsoever. That's like the one color I know I cannot wear, navy blue. That's not my thing. So I'm really happy I got a green one, and this Masada Milano Forever Cool Pencil costs €9.80. Okay, moving on to two more items in here, and then the box is empty. So the first thing is from Jelly Pong Pong. Oh, it's the Bare Necessities Highlighting Pencil. We already received this like a million and one times before. So honestly, I'm not even gonna get it out of here because I know I'm gonna give this away. And I'm kind of bummed though that it's in here. It's a very good eye primer. I use it for eye primer, don't get me wrong. And this lasts you like over 6 months, like between 6 months to a freaking year. That's how long this fella's gonna last you. But the only reason why I'm bummed out is because we received it so many times before. It's like a little bit overkill now. I'm kind of done with it. This is what that little like thing looks like. Like I said, we already received it, so I'm not gonna open it. It costs €17.95, and I will just show you guys in here in the booklet. This is what that pencil looks like when you get it out. So some of you might remember this who follow me for a long time. You've seen it often coming along and in my empties as well. So yeah, it's cool, but it's a bit overkill. And now we're down to the very last item in the box, which is this. And this is from Sugar. This is the Lash Mob Limitless Mascara in black with a bang. Okay, so this is what the little box looks like. It's pretty much exactly the same box that we received their, was it a liquid lipstick or gloss? I can't remember. It was red though, I remember that, but the box is the same. So I'm gonna assume all of their packaging is the same. Let's see, okay, pretty standard tube, nothing special. And then the brush is, okay, it's a standard brush. I can't really say a lot about this as I haven't tried it, but it is a standard brush, as you can see. And they claim that this mascara costs, oh, it's actually pretty cheap. It costs €8.60. Okay guys, that was it. That was this month's box. So we got the cuticle oil, the mascara, the Jelly Pong Pong eye primer, Bare Necessities, you can use it for a lot, a green eye pencil, and the six very just bad, badly placed eyeshadow, I can't call this a palette, it's like one thing. I think you could use this for a bronzer as well. What do I think? I love the cuticle oil. I love the look of this. This is just great aesthetic. It's very pleasing to the eye. I love it. And it feels really, really soft. So this is A++ in my game. I love the green pencil as well. Could have done without the Bare Necessities. The mascara I am gonna try out. Never bad to have good mascara. And this fella was just a letdown because this is just not freaking handy. It's a good solid box, I'm not gonna lie. But I will say something about Styletone. They used to be my favorite box. If you've been here for a while, then you should know that Styletone used to be my favorite box ever. It got replaced with the B-Lux box because the B-Lux box is stepping up their game. With Styletone, I feel like it's kind of going from here to, you know, over there. And the reason for that, what I personally feel like, is that Styletone is, lately, like in the last year, perhaps, yeah, definitely the last year or so, they have been concentrating and focusing way too much on other things than their actual products, than what this box was actually about. They have been focusing on a blog, on an unboxing, like a video type thing, on recipes, on I don't know how many fancy things like that were mentioned in this booklet. They had all of these great ideas, but I feel like the company should stop focusing on all of these other things and focus on your items, because this is what your box is all about. So focus solely on the inside of this box. It's about quality and not quantity. A lot of these companies do that when they want so much more. And I think what I personally feel like is, and these are just my thoughts, is that Styletone is trying to do something like the Look Fantastic box. That's like a really big company on its own. They've got more than these boxes. They've got an entire web shop and they've got so much more going on. It's a really international, big, solid company. And I feel like Styletone wants to go in that direction. But when it comes, I just feel like that kind of comes at a cost for the quality of the items in here. Again, this box is definitely one of the better boxes that we've received so far. I'm pretty pleased with the inside here. But still, I don't know if anybody from Styletone watches this. I don't think so. But if they do, try to focus more on the actual products than all of the other things around it. Because you know what? If you focus on the product, the people will come. I mean, people will subscribe to this box, and I think they have done so in the past because this box was amazing. We also used to receive like once or twice, I can't remember, I think it was once, maybe twice, I don't know, a year we used to receive a big box with a lot of items, like bigger items like body lotions, and once we received a full-size perfume, which was just, that was just amazing, and I feel like they cut out with that because they said they weren't going to do that. How about bringing that back? Because I know a lot of people really do want it. And that particular box doesn't have to be one brand only, but just like bigger items, just once a year. It should be doable just once a year. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in a comment section below. Do you think I'm right? If so, maybe if anybody ever watches this from Styletone, you guys could give your tips below because we are their customers in the end. And I do think that our opinion matters kind of most because once again, we're their customers. So let it be known down in the comment section below. I'd like to thank y'all so much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.